Hi, my lovely Magic the Gathering card tappers. I will be renewing a very old video that I made 2 years ago about how you can play Magic the Gathering online on Spelltable using Moxfield or Architect. I will show you with that example as well. I am now gonna show you step by step, unscripted, so you'll see everything I do, exactly how to do it. And I will only be using one monitor, so you can see how that works. Now, with OBS update, you actually have the virtual camera right inside of OBS. Okay, so inside OBS, we have a fresh new profile, fresh new scene, everything. This should be looking like your OBS if you got this version. This is the latest version running right now. And so we have our scene here and everything. Every source we put in our scene, it will be displayed using the virtual camera that's built in here right now. So we want that to be the program default. All right, just gonna use this scene. So now I want to add a window capture because we want to capture our window, which basically will be our Moxfield window. So here we have our Moxfield window. It automatically chooses that one, but if it chooses another one, you can go here under window and you can choose another one. Here we also have the Spelltable window I have in here. And so see here, it can choose, sometimes it want to choose a Spelltable one, but you can just switch here to the Moxfield window and press OK. I have Moxfield window. Now, we need to full screen this. So, and now when it's full screened in our OBS, it will also be full screened. We can just right click this, go to transform here and then fit the screen. It will automatically fit here. Also, a shortcut for this, you can just press Ctrl F and it will fit right in here perfectly. So test this out and see if it works. We're just gonna go and create a new game here. Test and see how it looks. So now we have to start our virtual camera. Boom, it's online. Ah, and now you can see everything here we displayed on OBS will be displayed here in Spelltable. But now we have to fix this up because we can't show all the people our hands and everything, right? Inside here in the window capture, we can right click to copy and then paste, duplicate. Or just Control C, however much times you want. And now what we can do here is that we want to hide our hand, right? So what we want to do is crop the underside of this. I'm going to hide the other sources for now so it's easier for you to see. And we can crop this by holding Alt, left Alt, we can crop here, so everything here disappears. Also, you have to be careful when you're inside Moxfield and hover a card, it will be displayed here to the right. And we don't want our enemies to accidentally see that. To fix that, we go into our OBS and we also cut out some from the right side. Just like that. Great. Now they see our battlefield. So we can play our cards, boom, 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 draw some cards, and they will only be able to see the battlefield. If it's too small, you can also choose to zoom in here. You can zoom in, zoom in, zoom in, zoom in. So the cards gets a little bit bigger, and by doing so, it will be easier for your allies to read the cards. But this also increases your hand size. So another way to fix this is actually just manually increasing here in OBS. Although this will change the quality a bit as well. But this should be good enough. They can see the cards. There are some other cool tricks that you can do. Maybe you want to show or the players you're playing with your library, graveyard, exile and everything like that in the command. You want to show them this part. You can do that. So this is why we duplicated our source. So if we take one back and put it on top here, it will be on the top side. And now we will just crop everything except for this part here. So we have our library and everything. Very nice. And now we can make this smaller and just put it here on the right side corner. Like that. So now we go into our Moxfield and see, oh, very nice. They can see our battlefield and they can see our library and graveyard and etc, etc. So here we are in the game and here you can see how it looks like in Spelltable right now. Looks very nice. Like this can really be enough. You don't have to do anything else. This is everything you need, pretty much. They can see your health. You have the health in game anyways, and they can see every information here and all that stuff. So practically, yeah, you could play with just one screen. See, Spelltable still here, right? I'm gonna make the screen a little bit little. It's gonna look a little bit funky on Spelltable now because we made the screen a little bit less bigger. But yeah, just to prove here, you can still play on one screen, do your shenanigan, and just go back to full screen or whatever you however you wanna play it. And they'll see all the updates. So it's good, it's working. And this is really all you need. You don't need anything else, but you could make it a lot more fancier if you want. On my last video, I showed you guys how to change the background and things like that. You click this big one, you go to filters, and you can add like a chroma key. So we go to color key and just pick out a color. So we're gonna go custom, and we're gonna pick this color picker. And we're gonna press the gray one on the screen here. And then it will delete all the gray area around here in the back. And what that allows us to do is essentially put any background here, so we can add any source, any picture, whatever. I'm just gonna put in a solid color just for an example. So we can just pick a color source. Let's make it green or purple. Yeah, purple, that sounds fine. Pull it all the way down here, so every other source get on top. And boom, we have a pink background playmat. Now, this can look a little bit funky, because Magic Cards also has the colors as the background, so they will get colored out or taken out. But you can adjust this a little bit. You could go in here and fix around with this. So, pulling down the similarity, we get some cards back. Something like that. Darker wallpapers will look better as they naturally blend into the art of the cards way better. See this one, this green thing? This green background really, really disappears inside the cards way better. But you can play around with that. You can put in a picture if you want. Doesn't really matter. You can have a video if you want. A media source. You can go all sorts of craziness, okay? I like this Black Myth Wukong background if you want to. Yeah, you can go really crazy. So, yeah, you can be really fancy with this. However you want. And that's practically it. There is nothing more magic or difficult or special about this. This is really everything that there is. Right, guys? So this is how you play with the newest update of OBS, with the virtual camera built inside of it. And also, just to show you, we can also do this. So I'm gonna close this window and show you on Architect. It's the same principle. We just choose window capture, we choose Architect, boom, playtester. Same thing here on the second window, boom, Architect, very nice, play that. And here we can see our library with our commander and everything, very nice. And you can see everything here, and also everything is reflected on Spelltable. They can see everything that you do here. Right? Very nice. Very good. Okay, guys, that's how you practically do it. It's super simple, nothing hard at all. And you saw everything raw, how I did it, so you can follow along really easily. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching my video. If you're still having any issues, leave them in the comments below. I'm very much more active now, so I will answer them and send you the updates on what you need to do. Good luck in your games. Bye.